The fifth A group element, that is nitrogen, most important compound is NH3, which can be named as ammonia. The most important nitrogen chemical substance is ammonia. Here, ammonia present in small quantities in air and soil. The quantity of ammonia present in air and soil generally resulting from the ammonia of soil and air resulting from decay of nitrogenous chemical substances. Nitrogenous chemical substances are fertilizers like urea. Means we can state a chemical reaction for which can show the availability of ammonia in air and soil as NH2CO, NH2. This is the molecular formula of urea. Urea, upon usage of urea, it reacts with water of atmospheric condition or water present in soil, produces ammonium carbonate, NH4 taken twice, CO3, ammonium carbonate. So urea, by reacting with water molecules of air and soil, it is converted into ammonium carbonate. This ammonium carbonate further decomposes to produce ammonia plus carbon dioxide plus H2O. So this is the availability of ammonia. Whereas in small scale quantity, ammonia produced from ammonium salts by reacting ammonium salts with caustic soda or calcium hydroxide, we can produce ammonia in the laboratory in small quantities. So once again, in small scale quantity, ammonia produced from ammonium salts and caustic soda or calcium hydroxide. That means when ammonium salts reacts either with caustic soda or with calcium hydroxide, they are bases. So finally yields as the formation of ammonia in the laboratory. So we can state a general reaction for the formation of ammonia in the laboratory as ammonium salts like NH4 taken twice, SO4. The name of this compound is ammonium sulfate. It is an ammonium salt. Ammonium sulfate, when reacts with calcium hydroxide, it yields us the formation of NH3 plus CaSO4 plus H2O. The formation of calcium sulfate. Similarly, the same will be expected from NH4Cl. The aqueous solution of ammonium chloride when reacted with same calcium hydroxide, which produces ammonia plus calcium chloride plus water. So these are the chemical equations which results as the formation of ammonia in small scale quantity from ammonium salts. Whereas the most important preparation, that means whenever we require ammonia in large scale quantity, ammonia in large scale quantity, it is better to produce by using Haber's process. Haber's process. The most important method for the preparation of ammonia from nitrogen gas and hydrogen gas is Haber's process. So let us learn how the ammonia prepared from Haber's process. Here, once again, ammonia in large scale quantity produced from Haber's process. In this method, nitrogen gas, we can show it as this. Nitrogen gas reacts with hydrogen gas. It is also gas. Finally yields us the formation of ammonia, NH3. Here, during the reaction, there is the change in enthalpy, 41.6 kilojoule per mole. So this is the most important chemical equation which indicates the formation of ammonia in large scale quantity from Haber's process. Here, according to or in accordance with, in accordance with Lee-Chatelier principle, that means according to Lee-Chatelier principle, high pressure would favor the formation of ammonia. That means from this method, Haber's process, if we want to produce huge yield of ammonia, so we require to maintain high pressure condition during the reaction. So what is the pressure condition used during the reaction for the preparation of ammonia in Haber's method? So once again, in large scale quantity, ammonia can freely or easily produced from Haber's process. So here, in Haber's process, we require to maintain high pressure.